Now to the latest edition of the NewsHour bookshelf. Paul Beatty's new novel, The Sellout, takes an unflinching, at times, comic look at race in America. Jeffrey Brown recently sat down with Beatty at Busboys and Poets, a Washington area bookstore.
Well, Paul Beatty, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
This is a thorough skewering, through humor, of racial politics today, and no one is spared. Hmm. What set you off? I mean, what are you responding to?
I'm just kind of responding to myself, I guess. You know, it's not like there's some impetus that's like, oh, I got to write about that. It's just stuff that I've been thinking about for a long time, and I've just been thinking about segregation for some reason. No, I think I'd read something about somebody saying, oh, black people were better off under segregation. And I just went, oh, it would be so fun to try to see how segregation would work now in a weird kind of guise.
So your character, nameless character, young black man, he tries to resegregate his city, in a sense.
Which is already,
in order to save it, right?
Yeah.
Strangely enough.
Yeah, he doesn't know that he's doing that, and that the city's already segregated.
It's de facto. I mean, yeah. it is segregated.
In many different ways, you know? Yeah.
As is much of our life today.
Exactly.
Still.
It's interesting in the book how acknowledging that you're being segregated changes your behavior a little bit.
But it allows you to look at every black piety, at every liberal piety. I mean, it's easy in a way to kind of skewer out and out racism.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
You're getting everybody.
Yeah, I think it's, you know, I'm not very pious about anything, unfortunately. But, you know, I'm skewering myself first. You know, I'm skewering things that I care about and things that are important to me. And then just my own foibles. For me, it's just this stuff that I'm thinking about, like these absurdities in the way we talk about race, class, culture, education, politics.
What absurdities? What do we get wrong?
We get it all wrong. There's no right. And I think that's part of it, is like we think that there's this weird, you know, utopian end game to life, you know, not just racial politics. And for me, it's a weird way to try to live life. And it's not to say that we shouldn't aspire to those things, but so a thing that I've been hearing about lately is some people always say, oh, it's hard to talk about race, you know, we can't have the discussion. I'm like, well, what does that really mean? You know, I don't understand what that discussion is, and we're this metaphorical table, you know, we've got to come to the table. I don't know where these tables are. So, yeah, I get to set my own table a little bit.
You know, at the same time, though, of course, these are very serious issues. In your book, the narrator's father is shot by police in an area around Los Angeles. And that's very real stuff.
Yeah.
But your approach is completely through humor.
Yeah, through humor and through my own experience. So like the shooting is something that's sort of personal to me. You know, it wasn't like, oh, people are getting shot, let me write about that. And I'm really starting from myself, and I'm not starting from current events or what's in the news or, you know, some Time magazine sidebar about this stuff.
Are we too squeamish? I mean, I was thinking to myself, one of the problems I have, even in quoting from the book, is your very liberal use of the N-word.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? We can't sit here and read it. We can't quote from it too much. Are we too squeamish? Are we just not talking?
I think we it's like, like when I used to read poetry, people would bring me into like, you know, some high school to read, and I would say the F word or something, and everybody acts so surprised, like, oh, I've never heard this word before, you know, but they're saying it 5 minutes later. So I think there's a weird, you know, there's this line between propriety and how we really speak and how we really think. And I'm just trying to have fun with that stuff. And you're talking about the word nigger. I can't say N-word for it. I just can't even let myself say it because it's so ridiculous. But, you know, there's a part of the book where the characters are talking about Mark Twain's, you know, Huckleberry Finn. And that word is all throughout there. And, you know, this effort to erase that. And so it's weird. I'm not sure why we're trying to erase these things, why we try to use these euphemisms all the time. Like, what purpose is that serving?
Is this kind of big satire hard to pull off?
I don't try to be satirical. I just try to get what's in my head on the page. And that part is hard for me to do. It takes a long, long time, you know, to make it poetic, somewhat essayistic, you know, and just I have a little bit of an agenda. That part's hard to pull off. And, you know, the book's about a big scope. You know, I think everybody focus on race, but it's about a ton of things. You know, and it's because I just see these things as all interrelated and all interwoven in a weird way.
And where does your sense, where does your love of writing come from, or your need to write?
I couldn't tell you because I can't say that I love writing, but I do love the satisfaction that it gives me. You know, it's just, it's really basic. I'm glad I found it late in life, and I'm glad I found it at all.
All right, the new novel is The Sellout. Paul Beatty, thanks so much.
Thanks for having me, Jeff. Thank you, man.